Hi, I'm Deborah Evans Price, author of the book Country Faith, and I'm sitting down with Country Music Rocks. What a privilege.
We're here at CRS 2014, and we're sitting down with Deborah Price, who recently released the book Country Faith. How are you, and how's your CRS week going so far?
Oh, Julia, it's going great. I always love CRS. You get to hear so much wonderful music, and you know, see a lot of people that you don't see very often.
Now, congratulations on the release of Country Faith. For folks that haven't picked it up yet, give us a little bit of background and tell us about the book.
Okay. I am so excited about this project because the book is quite simply country artists talking about their favorite Bible verses. And the publisher had the idea to do a book like this to get people further engaged in the Bible and asked me if I'd be interested in doing it. And it combines two things that are very special to me, country music and the good Lord.
Well, no, that's definitely a great combination. As we were getting the scripture verses in and putting them all together, what was going through your mind seeing what their thoughts were behind these verses that meant so much to them?
It was really cool because everybody had a different, you know, different verse and different reasons why it was important to them. You know, like Charlie Daniels chose Psalm 91 and told me this great story about being in Iraq. And he was on a helicopter going to perform for the troops in a remote location when they came under enemy fire. And he recited Psalm 91, the Psalm of Protection, and it gave him peace and comfort during a very difficult time. And so it was wonderful because everybody had a story behind why that particular scripture was so important to them. And what we did in doing the book is I kind of sat down and made a list of people that I knew that were believers that I thought would want to do a project like this. And then we gave them the option of either doing an interview and talking about the scripture and I would write it up for them, or if they chose to write their own, you know. Rodney Adkins wrote his own, and every time I read it, it makes me cry because he's talking about praying big, bold prayers and how God responds.
Now, with the success of the book and everybody's just really embraced it and loved it, is there plans for volume 2, do you think?
There are. As a matter of fact, I can't say with 100% certainty, but we've already been in discussions about a volume 2 and also doing maybe a Christmas Country Faith.
Very exciting. Now, in addition to the release of Country Faith, you also just recently won a CMA Media Achievement Award this past November, which is huge. Congratulations, first of all. And tell us a little bit about that and that experience for you.
Oh, thanks, Julia, for asking. That I've been in Nashville. Last fall was 30 years. I moved up here right after college. And I've written for Billboard magazine for almost 20 years. And I write for a lot of other places. And the night of the CMA Awards, I had been on the red carpet interviewing people for Billboard. So by the time that I got backstage at the awards and they were, you know, they got up to make an announcement, I was totally shocked. I had no idea that I would get that honor. And I was just, I tell you, I just grinned for probably 3 months straight. It's nice when you work hard and you care about the people that you're covering and then you feel like they've noticed and it means something to them. That was just such a blessing.
Oh, well, good for you. Now, you've been involved in the genre for so long now, and you've seen like all different aspects and sides of it. As country music is growing and evolving and just even changing a little bit, what is it that you love most about this genre?
I love country music's ability to tell great stories. You know, when you hear songs like Miranda Lambert's The House That Built Me, I mean, that's just something that everybody can relate to. And it's funny, I have a friend that says, oh, I don't listen to country music. And I played her that song, and she's like, oh my gosh, I need to start listening to country music. So that's the thing I think that I love most, is just the way that country music resonates with people. You know,
it definitely does. And finally, for folks that haven't got a chance to pick up Country Faith yet, tell us where they can find it or if they have to order it online, or give us a little background on where they can pick up Country Faith.
Okay, thanks for asking. It's available pretty much everywhere. It's at Sam's Club, it's at Barnes & Noble, it's at Christian retailers like Lifeway Christian Bookstores, and of course it's available on Amazon and all digital retail. And we also have a companion CD, Country Faith, that has got Brad Paisley's Those Crazy Christians, Dustin Lynch, Your Plan, it's got Carrie's Till I See You Again, Randy Travis, lots of great artists, and including a brand new song from Jimmy Wayne that he did specifically for Country Faith.
Well, that is great news. We'll have to definitely check that out. Thank you so much for taking the time to chat with us, and enjoy the rest of your time here in Nashville for CRS.
Oh, thank you, Julia. I appreciate you having me. Thank you.